Hi, I'm Ivan Yeremich, with Riverbed Support, and today I'm going to demonstrate how to decrypt SSL TLS browser traffic. If you are following us on our Riverbed Support YouTube channel, probably already saw the previous video, one of our previous videos that explains one of the really most used methods for decrypting SSL traffic with your Wireshark. But the biggest disadvantage of that method is that the fact that private key should not or cannot leave the client or server. So in that case, you have to approach responsible person for maintaining your web server. You have to get keys, you have to import those keys to Wireshark, and then you can get your traffic decrypted. So there is a second method that we are discussing today. We are discussing about this method today, and this method is based on the fact that some browsers keep logging symmetric session keys. When I'm saying some browsers, I mean Mozilla Firefox and Google Chrome. So those two browsers are supporting this method, and this method is not supported by Microsoft Internet Explorer and Microsoft Edge. The method, as I said, the method is based on symmetric session keys logs. We are going to extract those keys from some specific location. I will show you in my demo where this location is. So we are going to extract those keys, we are importing them to Wireshark, and we are getting our session decrypted. For the sake of demo, I will use Windows 10 operating system and Firefox browser. So Windows 7 is slightly, the method is slightly different. Just first few steps are different, because the graphical environment on Windows 7 is different than Windows 10. If you are using Linux or Mac operating system, those operating systems are also supporting this method of intercepting session keys and decrypting SSL traffic. But you can Google and you can find more information about them somewhere on the internet. So let's focus on Windows operating system, and after finishing this demo, you will see your traffic decrypted. You will see at the bottom of your Wireshark window, you will see decrypted SSL data. That is gonna be definitely the proof that your traffic is decrypted in this session. So let's jump to demo. The first step is going to be location. We have to choose the location where this session keys is going to be stored. So in my case, you can choose whatever location you prefer, whatever you like. In my case, I'm using just document folder. I'm going to create one folder inside, and that folder is SSL key folder. That's the name of my folder. Inside this folder, we will keep those session keys. Then we have to jump to control panel. Okay, let me just close and go step by step. We have to jump to control panel. From the control panel, your view has to be small icons. So the default one in Windows 10 is category, but please change it to small icons, because this is the key view for the next step. So then you have to navigate to system. From system, you have to navigate to advanced system settings, and then you're getting the main window for this method of intercepting SSL traffic. This main window is giving you possibility to create environment variable. So let's create one. Let's click on new. Let's call this one SSL key log file, and let's point this one to the location and to folder that we recently created. So let's go to this PC documents. Let's find our SSL key. And at the end of the path, please, this is the key. This is the key step, and this is the key fact. You have to create your SSL key log. So the name can be whatever you like, but the extension is really important. Extension has to be .log. Let's confirm that. Let's say okay. So this is our variable. Let's close this one. Okay. Let's say okay. So the next step is going to be capturing our TCP traffic, our SSL traffic. I'm starting my Wireshark. This is my Ethernet adapter that is currently connected, so there is some traffic. And let's initiate one SSL TLS connection. I will open, in my case, https://youtube.com. Let's see what is currently trending here. Let's see, sports section. So we are generating some traffic. Fantastic. Let's minimize this one and let's stop our capture. So there is some traffic in the background. I have also few more browser instances in the background running. But okay, let's find our YouTube traffic. I will use display filter frame contains YouTube.com, and then we will see some traffic related to this encrypted HTTPS session www.youtube.com. Let's follow the first one. So if you are following this TCP stream, we can't see anything, everything is encrypted. So at the beginning of this session you will see three-way handshake, then you can see established SSL session. So at some point we have exchange certificates here, we have pre-master secret, master secret, and then our application data are fully encrypted. You can see under the secure socket layer we are using TLS 1.2 and our encrypted application data. So not readable, not understandable, everything is encrypted and nothing can be seen inside. No, we can't really know what is inside this packet, what is the content of the packet. Same with the next one, so whatever application data you're checking, everything is encrypted. Let's try to decrypt this SSL traffic. So we have to change preferences for our protocols. Let's choose here SSL. From the pre-master secret log file name, we have to choose our SSL key folder and our SSL key log file. This is the file that is keeping all our session keys. After clicking save and OK, I'm expecting to see some decrypted traffic. So I'm definitely seeing here some readable content. So I'm seeing HTTP version 2. I'm seeing again decrypted traffic. If you're checking here, the bottom of your Wireshark, you see, we'll see decrypted SSL data, and also under secure socket layer, encrypted application data, and then HTTP version 2 appeared. So we can see our HTTP traffic. Our data are definitely decrypted in this case. As you can see, method is quite simple, not really difficult, but it's based on some sort of man in the middle. So I'm doing man in the middle on my own PC. I am intercepting keys. I am taking those keys from some specific location, importing them to my Wireshark and decrypting SSL session. I would like to show you one more thing here. Let's go to our documents. Let's go to our SSL key and let's just open our SSL key. So you will see a bunch of keys here. Symmetric session keys kept in this log file. Again, the previous method that we described in our older videos are also valid, also usable, slightly longer, slightly complicated method. But the main difference and the main disadvantage of that method is that private key should not or cannot leave the client or server. Here, if you are troubleshooting your session between your PC, between your client and let's say client steelhead, you can easily intercept those SSL packets. You can intercept SSL keys and decrypt your SSL traffic. So this was everything from my side for today. I do hope that you get some useful info out of this video, and thanks a lot for watching.